You know, everywhere I go, I always talk about when I was a kid, you know, the memories I have of, you know, the berry bushes around my grandfather's cabin. There's just acres of berries, raspberries, blueberries in the summer. And I remember just pigging out to the point where I was going to get sick. And I remember my uncles and my cousins, you know, bringing in the nets and just more fish than you could even imagine, you know. And I remember bush people that would come in, because my grandparents were medicine people, and bush families would come in from, I just remember like being a kid and then bush people coming out of the forest, and they'd have like a hind quarter of a moose and come and trade my grandparents for medicine, and be having moose meat that night, you know. And we have to stop, you know, trying to live our lives better and just learn how to be happy living our lives well, you know. And I just think that, you know, with the global economic crisis, the loss of natural capital to sustain the current economic paradigm, the end of the era of cheap oil, you know, the Canadian tar sands represents peak oil. It represents the bottom of the barrel, the muck they're scraping off the bottom. It represents the end of the era of big oil. And, you know, we didn't leave the Stone Age for lack of stones, you know. We left because there was other technologies that we could utilize that made our lives better. And it's the same thing with, you know, conservation, renewable technologies, and just really, you know, taking a look at consumption. And, you know, we really have to explore, you know, these notions around the radical redistribution of wealth and land, you know, in the north. Because we're already locked into a certain, you know, degree of climate change. And, you know, mark my words, in the next decade, there'll be massive, massive unrest. Many of the conflicts in Africa are already, you know, wars driven by climate change, because farmers can no longer farm, so they're driven to the mines, you know, and these mining companies and these oil companies destabilize the governments there so they can continue to extract the resources with no environmental oversight.
Industry has to be taken to task and clean it up better. And, you know, they're supposed to be our neighbors, and yet they're killing us. 100 years from now, you say, three generations. What's going to be left here, you know? A desert? This place used to be populated with porcupine and skunks. When Great Canadian Oil Sands came in the mid-60s here, they took off. Still not around today. Near the closest I've ever seen a skunk or a porcupine would probably be House River. That's as far as north they would come in this area. And then you could go towards Wabasca and whatnot around the other highway over there, and there's lots of them over there and all around just within this area here. Something to do with the tar sand. They don't like it, you know. They've been gone, but at one point in the up till the mid-60s, when industry started coming in here, there was lots.